As soon as you get in the gate, all the people and all the media and stuff, it's a lot bigger than I expected.
If at first you don't succeed, then try again. At 52, Wes Short Jr. is the oldest player at this year's US Open and living proof that after 34 years of frustration and disappointment, perseverance can and does eventually pay off.
To tell you the truth, it seemed like after all the years that I didn't know if I was ever going to play in one. And there's two tournaments when I was a kid, I always wanted to play in. One was, of course, the Masters, and the second was the US Open, being from the United States.
For Short, the journey to a first ever US Open has actually been rather long, having first tried to qualify as an 18-year-old high schooler in his native Texas back in 1982. He never gave up on his dream, though, and after playing in a seniors event in Iowa earlier this month, he made a late-night dash to Ohio for his latest qualifying attempt, not even arriving at his hotel until the early hours of the morning.
The hardest part was the 36 holes on the 2.5 hour sleep. And actually, I don't think I've recovered yet. My legs are still barking at me right now.
It's fair to say that Short, who once worked in a stone quarry for his father, is very much a late bloomer, eventually getting his tour card at the age of 40, with his sole PGA Tour victory coming in 2005 when he beat Jim Furyk in a playoff in Las Vegas. Now, more than three decades after he first tried to qualify for the US Open, his admirable patience is being fully rewarded.
I always thought that I was good enough to play. One unfortunate about golf, to play golf, it costs a lot of money to play in tournaments and stuff. But what kept me motivated is actually I had friends that I grew up playing golf with, and they had like Jeff Maggard, and I mean, had some nice success. Eventually, you know, things worked out for me. So I wish I had done a little bit earlier in life, but you know, sometimes things are meant to happen a little later.
So Wes Short Jr. will finally realize his career golfing ambition when he tees off bright and early at just after 7 a.m. on Thursday morning. And the best part about it all, he'll be cheered on by 15 family members, wishing only great things for the soon-to-be grandfather. Patrick Snell, CNN, Oakmont Country Club.